Hello friends, in this video lecture we are going to discuss our next error detection technique, which is called as LRC. So this LRC stands for Longitudinal Redundancy Check. Okay. So what is the fund of longitudinal redundancy check? So to understand it better, first you have to understand the how many types of names it can be called as. It is also called as the block check character technique, that is BCC, or I'm writing it as block check character technique. Okay, because instead of adding single parity at the end of code word, it adds the block of parity code, block of codes, which are nothing but parities. Okay, so to understand it better, let us take an example. Suppose we have the original data provided as, suppose this sequence of code words we have with us 00111, so 111 00 111. Next we have is 110 11 01. Next block we have is 00 11 001, and next we have is 101 01. Okay, so how do we generate the parity using LRC technique? So for that, what we have to do, we have to simply take the data as one by one block at a time. So data is 111 00 111. Next block we have is 110 11 01. Next block we have is this, that is 00 11 001. Next block we have is 101 01 001. Okay, now we will detect the parities longitudinally. Instead of calculating it vertically, we'll calculate the parities as longitudinally. Okay, so we are taking even parity. If a parity concept is not mentioned, that what type of parity you have to maintain, then by default we'll be taking even parities. So to maintain the even parities longitudinally, we have to count the number of ones. Suppose we are taking this one, so number of ones are 1 2 3 4, so it is already maintained as even, so the parity bit will be 0. Okay, next, coming to next block, so we have one, so only we have this one singly and remaining are zeros, so now the number of ones are odd, so to make them even I'll add one. Similarly 1 2, so they are even, already maintained as even, so I'll add 0. Then here we'll add 1, here we'll add 0, here we'll add 1, here we'll add 0, here we'll add 1. Okay, so this is the parity code block, or called as LRC code for the given data. Okay, now the data which is actually going to be transmitted is our original data. The transmitted data will be, which will be transmitted as our original data, that is 111 00 111, then 110 11 01, then 00 11 001, then 101 01, and at last our LRC code, that is 101 01 010. Okay, so this is our original data plus LRC code that will be transmitted to the receiver. Okay, now to understand the basic problem with this technique, let us take the same example, or I have to do it suppose okay, I'm taking the another example. Now suppose while transmitting this data, that is our original data, that was 000, 00, 111, and 110, this, during transmission some of the bits gets changed or flipped. Okay, so what we need to do is we have to find out the received data. Data received at receiver's end. Suppose the received data is at receiver end is 000, 11, 00, 111, then 110, 11, 01, then 00, 11, 00, 11, and again 10, 10, 0011. So if we compare this data with our original block of code, original block of code was this. So I'm taking it as an example. Our original block of code was this. So if I compare it with the original data, so we can clearly see here that this bit and this bit are changed or flipped during transmission. Okay, and similarly this bit and this bit is already also flipped. But when we'll calculate its LRC, the LRC will again come as 10, 10, 10, 10. Okay, if you try to calculate, then please try to calculate this that LRC for this received data. You will find that LRC of this given code word is 1. So what is the major problem? We can conclude it as, that is, if two bits in one data unit, that is one code word or data unit, are damaged, we can say here two bits in one data bits are damaged, and two bits at exactly same position, at exactly same position in another data unit are also changed, or I'll write it as damaged. Okay, you can see here these two bits are at position, and at the similar positions these two bits are already also changed in another data unit. Then we can see LRC is not able to detect these errors, and LRC is generated as the original block. The original block's LRC was this. Okay, and the received LRC is also this. So in such cases, LRC will not be able to detect errors. Okay, so this is the drawback with this LRC technique. In VRC, we have seen that single bit errors are detected, but even number of bits are not detected. Whereas in LRC, the condition is, if two bits in one data unit are changed, and in another data unit, two bits are already changed at the exact same positions. Okay, then LRC is not detecting the errors. Okay, so what should we do? In such cases, we have another technique to detect the errors, that is the combination of LRC and VRC, that is VRC plus LRC. We have the combination of these two. That technique is called as two-dimensional parity check. Two-dimensional parity check. So this technique I will discuss in the next lecture. So till now, if you have any problem regarding VRC and LRC, you can ask in our comment section, and kindly subscribe our channel. Thank you so much.